I think to talk about how we highly engage with grantees, it's probably worth telling a little bit of a story of how we accidentally stumbled into that strategy. We were actually developing a program to honor and celebrate the most extraordinary nonprofit leaders in Boston. And what we thought we were doing is giving them time away through a sabbatical program and a trip together to help sort of disrupt them and get them bonded with each other. But one of the unintended consequences of this has been that the foundation itself has found itself in a much more authentic relationship with these same grantees and nonprofit leaders. So that we have now, we have 24 about to become 36, what we call Barr Fellows, who are nonprofit leaders in Boston, who we just have amazingly honest and authentic relationships with. So I feel like I can find out about something in a way that is just plain honest, which is a privilege for a foundation, because usually there's so much in between a foundation and a grantee that it's very hard to really know what's happening. One of the things that just happened this week is I actually had a group of them over to my house, and part of what happens in those conversations is we covered topics like how should foundations really work, what about racism, what about the violence in the city, what about global funding. I mean, the topics were broad-ranging, and they were just real dialogues that people weren't posturing about. They're not looking for grants, they're just sharing their wisdom, which is incredible, because there's an enormous amount of wisdom in grantees. I don't even like to call them grantees. I mean, part of what this is about is getting into genuine relationships. Probably the most important question, is this a closed circle? And the same question applies to when we hire staff. So we hire staff with good networks, but are those, you know, what's different about this than the old boy network? We're just creating different networks, right? And that is, I think, the danger. But if you really know about network theory, what you know is that healthy networks, innovative networks, pay attention to the periphery. It's all about connecting one network to another network. It's about seeing who's on the outside and inviting them to connect you to the next network so that you've got these small worlds that are connecting up. That's the importance of it. If you're just going to stay with a core group, then you're in trouble. What you're trying to choose is leaders who understand this in their own work, who know that part of what they're doing is pushing power out. And so that the theme is, how do you keep on becoming more inclusive? And how do you keep on reaching out to those who aren't in? That's a part of the underlying philosophy if you're really going to make it work.